We're confident that you'll handle this matter with discretion.
Strike one. Prepare for landing.
We've detected an exalt cell operating inside the German border. We'll need Strike one to rendezvous with our operative and assist in securing the needed intel. The operative was in position to transmit the data they'd acquired when Exalt forces moved into their AO. The encoder is currently shielding our transmitter's position, but if Exalt manages to hack the encoder, they'll be able to locate the transmitter. If they hack both, any hope we had of recovering the data intact will be lost. We have a new objective.
Orders confirmed. Moving out.
Rolling out.
Target confirmed. On our way.
Time to motor.
Exalt has a number of communications relays nearby. If our operative can get in close to one and use the encryption keys recovered with the enemy data, they should be able to temporarily disable Exalt's comm systems.
Double time.
These Exalt operatives appear to have undergone extensive genetic enhancement, suggesting Exalt has access to MELD as well as lab facilities on par with our own. However, I would never suggest we follow such an unrestrained approach to modifying the physiology of our own soldiers.
Commander, we have an Exalt unit attempting to hack the encoder. If we don't prevent them from gaining access, they're going to find the transmitter's coordinates.
Ugh, damn it!
Moving.
I'll get him next time.
Heading to that location.
We've disrupted the enemy communications network. It'll take some time for them to get it running again.
Got it covered.
On the move.
Enemy in sight.
On my way.
Missed the target.
Roger that.
Got it. Moving.
I'm about to start keeping score.
Time to motor.
Okay. Right. I've got my eyes on.
Got a wave of new signatures closing on Strike One, Commander. Multiple hostiles inbound.
Moving out. Roger that.
No way that just happened.
Dead and gone.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Get him next time.
That's affirmative. Hoorah! Heading to that location. He's down.
Hostile contacts closing at Strike One's position, Commander.
I'm on the move.
Roger that.
Getting it done. Man man up and get back out there.
Good to go.
Looks like this is the last of the hostile reinforcements, Commander. We just need to hold out a little longer.
That is not good.
Firepower over here.
Heading to that location. Weapons empty. Can't engage.
Scanning.
That's affirmative. Locked and loaded.
Shot wide.
They're on the move.
No! I want to go home!
Heading there now.
For the love of God, get me out of here!
Rolling.
Trying to flank us. They're flanking my position.
Kill confirmed.
Got it covered. Ready to engage.
Heading there now. That was close.
Can I get some help?
On the move.
Moving to position.
Exalt's troops are down and we've secured the transmitter. Well done.
Exalt intel decryption complete, eliminating statistical improbabilities for possible Exalt location.
Thank you.
Operational.
Commander, the genetics lab is now prepped and fully staffed. We can begin genetic modification of our soldiers on your order. This facility will be the nerve center of our genetic modification program. Our soldiers will receive entirely new capabilities, making them more effective on the battlefields than ever before. As we improve our understanding of alien genetics, the range of available modifications will expand. The meld substance has been enormously valuable in advancing our theories on genetic modification. So far, we've been limited to the augmentation of existing human organs. With the latest autopsy results, we now have the option of incorporating alien physiology into our genetic enhancement programs. It may be asking too much of our soldiers. They would be even more capable on the battlefield.
Tell them to get some rest.
I'll have the selected volunteer sent to surgical prep immediately. Once the genetic modification is complete, I will notify you directly.
Online.
The soldiers who volunteer for mech trooper augmentation sacrifice much, but they do not leave themselves entirely behind. A mech trooper will be able to apply some of the training and knowledge from his or her previous combat specialty to the cybersuit's operation. With this facility, we'll be able to build mechanized exoskeletal cybersuits, or mechs, and implant our soldiers with the cybernetic interfaces they'll need to deploy these mechs onto the battlefield. We'll consult with Dr. Valland for the requisite amputation. The cybernetic interfaces are holding stable, but they're of no use without a cybersuit to interface with. I suggest we manufacture one immediately. When our new mech trooper equips that suit, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised with its capabilities. lower stream will burn not only the cone of Mechtrooper, but will spill into nearby areas as well.
If we don't address the lack of available scientists in the lab soon, we run the risk of falling behind on our research.
Lab online. Excavation complete. Contact detected.
Mission site setting down.
We're dropping you just inside the Egyptian border. It looks like the UFO landed out in the boonies. We need to secure the surrounding area and eliminate any hostiles before they threaten the local population. Roger that, Big Sky. Strike one, you are green to deploy. Approach with extreme caution. Current enemy status at the site is unknown.
Let's do this.
Double time.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Four. Alien object in sight.
I'll move like the wind.
Confirmed. Moving out.
Moving out.
Heading out. I have it covered.
To retrieve those canisters rather than destroying them.
Attempting to retreat. Connecting sights.
Position confirmed. I have it covered. On the move. Let's rock. Moving out. Overwatch, aye aye.
Reloaded.
Watching for activity.
Shh. You hear that?